everyone, your faithful host Leah here. Before we jump into the podcast, I wanted to remind everyone that all of our podcasts are pre-recorded so that Steven can work his magic. We didn't know it when we recorded this episode, but these were much simpler times. So your commute may look different and your cleaning session may be more intense, but we hope this episode brings you as much laughter as we had while making it. Stay healthy, folks.
You're next in line for the official Holiday World Podcast.
Welcome to Holiday World and Splash and Safari.
Dropping in from Santa Claus, Indiana.
Riders will experience swift acceleration, high-speed turns, and sudden stops.
With Park President and CEO, Matt Eckert.
We're trying to keep our podcast short, remember?
Fourth-generation owners, Lauren Crosby.
We've been through this in the last episode.
And Director of Communications, Leah Cook.
Some things will stay around forever.
Now stow your loose articles, buckle up.
And please keep your hands and legs inside the car at all times.
And we're back. Welcome back to season two of the official Holiday World podcast. This is season two, episode nine, the one with all the food. Today is February 7th for us, but we plan to air this March 30th. Today on our show, we have, once again, Matt Bloomhart, Vice President of Revenue.
We let him come back.
Hello. I like how he's just like freezing at the mic right now. He looks like he's about to say something and then he just didn't. And also we have Lori Gogol, Director of Revenue Administration and also expert food purchaser.
Hello.
Welcome, Lori.
As we just experienced.
Thank you. Yes. All right. Now, Matt already answered this question in the last podcast episode. So we have an icebreaker question for you. If you could add one section or ride to the park, what would it be and why?
Well, my history came from the water park, so
sure.
It's definitely got to be in the water park. And what ride in the water park? That's hard because all my favorite rides are already
all
in
your
the
dreams
water park.
Have come true in the water park.
We already have them all.
Yeah.
So maybe a nice cabana village.
Yeah,
a nice big lazy cabana village with its own little pool. Yeah, that'd be my favorite.
So you're kind of combining your water park and your food and beverage experience putting them all together.
Yeah.
Nice.
Nice.
Love it. All right. Tell us how you got started with Holiday World.
Well, I started back in 1994.
Nice.
I actually started seasonally with Vanessa Kellums. You guys talked to Vanessa in the earlier episode. Vanessa and I actually started on the same day.
Wow.
Yeah. Funny story. Vanessa and I, she's going to kill me for telling this, but we came in later in the season. We didn't start when all the other employees started. Uh-huh. So we did orientation different. They used to videotape orientation, someone doing it. And then they'd show you the VHS sitting
That's
in
amazing.
A room. And there's all these teenagers and me and Vanessa watching this VHS tape of orientation.
VHS.
Yeah.
Right.
So anyway.
You really just aged yourself there, Lori.
I know I did.
That's awesome.
And somebody might or might not have fast-forwarded the videotape of the boring orientation.
Shame, shame. That explains so much about you, Lori.
No.
Now I know why you never know anything about the park, except I would call you for literally any problem I've ever had in the park. Oh, my gosh.
But anyway, started in 94 seasonally as a lifeguard. And in 97, started full-time in the water park and have stayed ever since full-time. Done various roles. Did the water park director for about 20.
Yep.
And then just been kind of moving around. And I've been in my most recent role, for 2 years.
Nice.
And we're glad to have you in revenue.
Well, I'm glad to be in revenue.
Yes.
I love making money for the park.
Lori
is not only an expert food purchaser, but she's also got some pretty great negotiating skills.
Yes.
So she's very good at negotiating contracts and working with our vendors. And
those are valuable skills.
Yeah.
Very
I feel like every
skills.
Other day I hear something of like, oh, yeah, Lori negotiated that. It's a lot better now. It's like, wait, what? We can negotiate that? Just like anything that I thought was non-negotiable, Lori's like, no, we can negotiate that.
And as Leah mentioned, with Lori being here so many years, she's got a lot of tribal knowledge too about the park and its history and the way we do things. And yeah, she's a good resource.
Yeah.
You guys are making me blush this morning. Thank you.
People can't see you except us. So
okay, good.
Also, I have to add that one of my favorite things about Lori Gogol is that whenever we get her laughing, she cries.
This is true.
I'm just thinking of the day that our vice president.
No, I'll come start crying. Eric Snow, that's all you have to say.
Is this when he fell on the
mammoth conveyor belt?
Have we shared this already?
I think we've shared this recently.
But it's a story you can share over and over again, and it's still as funny.
We had a news crew in. It was the day we announced Thunderbird, and we had news crews coming in bright and early.
So
we were trying to kind of misdirect and take people into the water park and, you know, have them ride some water park rides. So we ended the morning on Mammoth with some news personalities.
Ended at like 6.
The first round of things. And so we had to have some people on to ride. So all of us stepped up, but Eric also stepped in and helped ride.
Yep.
And when we finished, they stopped the conveyor at the precise moment that he was standing up somehow.
And like picked up one foot to like get out of the raft.
And that conveyor is very soft and bouncy, we should add. But he literally just bounced when he hit.
And it was a straight
body
fall.
Slam.
It was a straight fall. Like there was no like knees first.
Yeah, it's like on the back.
It was like a turtle on the back of the shell. You know, couldn't move.
And he hit and then he bounced.
Do you realize the value of a video of this would have had.
Oh my god!
Funny you say that, because after that, I shouldn't admit this because this is the number one sin of like costume characters. But like Lori then sent us a video of like costume characters falling and like losing their heads, and it was she cried while we laughed, like while we watched that one too.
Oh my goodness!
Thank you, Eric, for providing countless hours of laughter.
Thank you. Also. For the record, if you ever see a costume character fall and lose their head, please check on them first and then delete that video for their dignity. But also, since they're already out there, we did laugh. Yes.
Yes.
Anyway, we're not here today to talk about all of that. We've already collected brown plates of food today because I've got a picture of all the brown on my plate. We're talking about all the new food for 2020.
Okay. Lori,
where do we want to start?
Oh my gosh, where do we start? Well, I'll start with my favorite, and especially my favorite that we had today, and that's the breaded tenderloin.
It was so good.
It was really good. Amazing.
This is an Indiana delicacy, you guys. I don't know that everybody understands that.
Interesting story. When this first came up, I was talking to Bloomheart about it, and he's like, I've never had a tenderloin. I'm like, why did we hire you?
That's the first time you asked me that question.
Do you want to pull at that thread? Or?
Right. Good grief.
But that's funny because it was Matt Bloomhart's idea to bring the tenderloin here because that's an Indiana thing. So he's very, very much strong
on. Awesome tenderloins are.
Yeah. And it was like, well, it's an Indiana thing. Yeah. And I think it was that. And oh, the other item, well, we'll talk about it later. Sugar cream pie. I think that's
Oh, yeah.
We brought that at last
Indiana
year.
Indiana state pie.
Yeah.
And yeah, I didn't know that is the Indiana state pie.
I hadn't had that before either.
Yeah.
So, I can forgive you for that.
Yeah.
The tenderloin, not
the tenderloin.
So we've already tried the pork tenderloin because I know some people are very sensitive to the sounds of people eating. So we've already gotten most of our eating done ahead of time. You're welcome. But guys, what'd you guys think of the pork tenderloin?
I loved
so,
it.
So good.
It is such it a tasty good. Tenderloin.
Despite being a Hoosier, I'm not big on pork tenderloins.
But you had one.
Yep. Yes.
Oh, yeah.
Exactly.
But I really did actually like this one. It was very tasty.
Now, how will we be serving that? I mean, you know, the tenderloin.
Yeah, it'll be served on a bun with lettuce, tomato, and then, of course, your choice of condiments.
Yes.
And it'll be served at Wilde Bistro and Goblin Burgers.
Nice. And I just want to let everyone know that in Indiana, it is customary to eat your tenderloin with mustard.
And maybe a little mayo.
And some horseradish sometimes.
Yeah. But this is, you know, you don't put ketchup on it.
Not
ketchup territory.
No. I usually just go with mayo.
We're a little
pickles.
Like Chicago.
Yeah,
though.
Me too, mayo.
Sometimes onion a little bit, maybe. But
you know, Chicago, you don't put ketchup on a hot dog. I was at the Chicago airport recently.
Really?
And at a hot dog stand in the airport, and it said, like, do not ask for ketchup on your hot dog. I was like, oh, dang.
That's incredible.
Do they eat anything on their hot dogs?
That's incredible.
They do mustard.
Yeah.
Just mustard.
They also have like a Chicago style that's like got relish and celery salt and
I need ketchup
onions
on my hot dog.
Chicago style is the best for the record. Okay. It's so good. Anyway,
you probably just started a war, but
fight me. All you listeners, come at me. No, please don't. So
we have breaded tenderloin.
Yes.
And then some of the other favorites that around this table really liked was the crab rangoon. Mm-hmm.
Very tasty.
Literally yummy. So excited for this, guys.
Yeah. It's so delicious. And it's by itself. We decided you don't need a dipping sauce or anything. Yeah. It's just by itself. And we're going to have that up at Santa's Mary Marketplace.
I will get that every time. We'll have it in the Asian section. I will get something else and crab rangoon every time for the record, in case anyone was wondering.
Yeah. It was so good. Another thing is fried avocado.
So tasty.
It's a deep fried avocado bite, and we'll serve that at Wilde Bistro this year. And it is very good.
I can just imagine, like, you know, watching your kids of a Timbo just munching on your fried avocado.
So tasty.
It sounds very relaxing to me.
I will admit, I was skeptical of that, but it was really good.
It was. It was like real crispy on the outside, but it was real creamy. The avocado was creamy. Yeah. Even if you don't love avocado, it was good.
Yeah. It's like for a fried snack, it wasn't like super heavy.
It makes you feel like you're eating a healthy fried snack.
Yeah. Avocado. Avocado's new and big.
That's about as good as we get in Indiana, isn't it?
Fried
we'll get the avocado, but we will fry it first.
You got to fry it.
At least we know what state we come from.
Exactly.
You know?
And we're proud of it. We own it.
And then one of the other samples we tried this morning is the churro donut. So sticking with the breakfast theme.
It's my favorite.
I'm so excited.
So much cinnamon sugar.
I still got some on my plate and I'm just like saving it.
We even had Sabrina say she doesn't like donuts, but she liked this.
It is so tasty.
And it's so different than a regular donut. It's shaped like a donut, but it tastes a little more like a churro, but it's not crispy like a churro.
It literally is like a churro and donut had a baby.
And then
so it's like a chonut.
No.
We're done with the.
I kind of like that.
No.
Thanks for calling a chona instead, Lori.
We're not.
No.
It's going on the menu.
We get it. No. Cronut happened. Let's move on.
And then that churro donut, the chona will be served.
No, stop it.
Or a do-ro.
At the Alamo.
And it'll be served warm. So it comes out of the oven and it's nice and warm and has sugar on it. Oh.
Cinnamon sugar on the outside.
Why these
words?
I quit the podcast, guys. I'll see
you guys
later.
We're taking over, Matt.
The Mats are taking over.
So that'll be at the Alamo.
Yes. Okay. Now, this next item that we tried today, I need to make sure that we have Steven on board and ready to answer a question for me.
I'm here.
Okay.
Hey, Steven.
When I mentioned to Steven the new foods that we would be trying in this episode, he went, "There's a new fry," and I went, "Yes." And he said, "Please don't tell me we're changing the fries." And I said,
"What?
Changing the fries?" Steven, apparently we found fan, because I'm gonna be honest, I was not a fan of our fries.
My kids have been complaining since we switched.
Yeah. I don't like.
Steven,
our fries.
What's the justification?
It's so funny because, like,
explain yourself.
Okay, so first of all, I'm okay with going against the trend. Okay, I'm all right being the lone wolf. But the flavor of the fry was really what I was what I really liked. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you let them sit for a little while. They got a little squishy, mushy, whatever.
Not a little.
You know.
They got a lot.
But the flavor of the fry, especially when they were very fresh, I really liked them. And, you know, I'm one of those people that, and I'm probably going to start
another war here.
Okay, come on. You get like the ketchup and the mayonnaise and you put it together and, you know, you kind of get that little twangy, you know,
mayo
sauce that you dip.
You just made a gross face.
That's okay. That's okay. She doesn't have to eat my food.
Steven.
So
we're
anyway,
not asking him about food anymore.
Steven, turn your mic off. No, I'm kidding.
Okay. Okay. So, but you bring in the new fries, and I'll let you talk about them, and then I'll give you my verdict on them.
So I want to say that the reason that we have this fry is because I listen to NPR podcasts a lot, and I listened to this one episode of Planet Money and said, "Matt, have you guys tried this stuff?" And he goes, "What?" And so I play him this whole episode, make him sit through 20 minutes of Planet Money, and I go, "This fry, it's called Crispy on Delivery." And it's basically like they tell this whole story of how, what's the company?
Lamb Weston.
Yeah. Lamb Weston. And they create a product called Stealth that helps keep fries fresh for longer. But basically they saw this trend coming that people are starting to do delivery with a lot of fast food. And they saw it happening in China. And so they started developing a product so that now, as people are starting to do fast food delivery, they've got this product already ready to go. And it doesn't it use like all natural potato parts to like do this? Isn't like a weird like potato
all
coating?
All natural potato,
potato parts.
Yeah.
Potato parts.
Wow, these sound amazing.
I'm definitely not in charge of describing the food.
How many parts does a potato have? Like the potato and the
potato
skin.
Properties. That's the word I was looking for. Okay. Natural properties of the potato is my understanding. But basically, now these fries stay crispy for half an hour.
Lori has an info sheet over there.
I've got an info sheet. It says
she's got the real
facts. Take over, Lori.
So, here we go.
Show me up, please. Now. They have potato parts.
There's potato parts in the French fry, and it's also a traditional fry with revolutionary light batter that maintains crispness for up to 20 minutes.
Okay, 20 minutes.
But Steve tested it this morning.
Yeah.
It sat there for an hour under no heat lamp, under nothing but a piece of tinfoil.
Lori arrived nice and early with the food.
We were not ready.
We were not prepared.
Yeah, so they had to smell it.
The last episode went a little long.
And they were, after over an hour of no heat lamp or anything.
Just sitting on a table.
They were still
crispy.
Okay, I'm going to give you guys a warning. Matt's about to take a bite of his fry. So if you're not a person who likes
it,
skip ahead for a second.
Matt B or Bloomheart
is about to take a bite of this fry. That was like an hour.
Could
you hear long after?
Yes, we totally heard it.
We're going on probably an hour and a half.
Oh, at least.
Or maybe 2 hours.
Oh, actually, it's closer
it's
to 2 hours.
But
still
not so crispy that it hurts your tooth. Your tooth's still fine.
No, I don't.
No, it's
don't have
definitely
any issue
not
with
tough
teeth
or anything like that.
And it's tasty.
We are overselling this and doing a bad job at this point.
I think everybody's going
to
want to try
people.
It now.
Yeah. Lamb Weston are very happy now.
People want to know what a potato part is, Leah.
Yeah. So anyway, okay. We got to go back to Steven, though, because Steven is the ultimate judge here because we had to win him over. So, Steven.
Still don't understand that love of that French fry, but.
Do you approve of the change?
I do.
Okay.
Because it's like.
So is there like a hallelujah soundbite that you're going to throw in here?
Well, and it wasn't like I was married to the old fries. I just liked the taste of them. These, the consistency of these was much better, even at a longer time sitting out. And so I think that this is going to be, especially with the time that we're serving them in short amounts of time and stuff like that, I think that the guest is really going to see a difference in the time that it takes to get to the end of their meal. Their fries aren't going to go mushy.
And as much as our food and beverage team does a great job, but, you know, we know that sometimes things happen and that, you know, it may take you a while to get from the fry to your table. Maybe our tables are all full and you take a while to find one or something like that. We know that things happen. And so 20 minutes to keep your fries fresh, I think is really impressive.
Yeah.
And I'm really happy I listened to that podcast episode.
We are too.
I think, you know, you made me listen to it and then I didn't take any action on it for probably a month or two. And I think I asked you like 3 or 4 times, hey, what was the name of that fry again?
Yes. He kept doing it.
I think I kept slaughtering the name too. I don't know what I was calling it, but it took me like 4 or 5 different times.
The one with the potato parts.
Yes. The one with the potato parts.
Leah, you're never going to live this down.
Never.
I really just want a guest now to walk up to the counter and say, now, these fries, are they made with real potato parts?
This is going to be, remember back when we had, what was the show that was coming? We had all of the, like, performers that had different skills. So we had the Silks performer at, thank you. That was the name of the show. We had our break dancer. And I was texting with Paula the day that they were starting to kind of put the show together. And I was like, just kept texting her pictures because we had a guy on a unicycle and a girl with silks and a girl with a hula hoop. And I was like, this is so cool. And she's like, I'm glad to see. She tried to text. I'm glad to see you're so excited. But she accidentally put SP instead of so. And she had her phone trained to correct to season pass.
Yes.
And so she texted, I'm glad you're season pass excited. And I will never, I will always make sure that story is alive. Okay. So potato parts is my season pass excited.
It became a whole thing. We then had the break dancer stand like upside down on one hand. And he like was jumping around going, I'm season pass excited.
Really fast.
It did not die
either. I believe Paula created a blog post, which we'll share in this blog post, but I think it's like the typo heard around the world or something like that. Like it's like, yep, that was it. Yep.
Are you the type of person who likes to constantly be on the move and always be on your toes? The type of person who likes to get one-on-one interaction with our awesome guests? What about working with your hands to get a project done the way you think it should be done? If you answered yes to any one of these questions, then Food and Beverage has a job that will fit you perfectly. No matter the person, Food and Beverage always has a place that'll guarantee you have the best summer you've ever had.
Want to make a suggestion or have questions for the Pod Squad? There are more ways than ever to reach out to the podcast.
Find at Holiday World on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram, and use the hashtag HOWOPO to let us know you're talking about us.
You can now call us. Dial 812-937-4401 and type in extension 8081 to get to the HOWOPO voicemail box.
Leave your questions and feedback for us there, or you can email us at podcast@holidayworld.com, either with a written message or with a voice memo.
Again, reach out on social media to @holidayworld and use the hashtag HOWOPO, or call us at 812-937-4401, extension 8081, or send us an email to podcast@holidayworld.com.
Did you know if you purchase our Pick Your Price tickets online, you can save money? Save a little bit more by using the official Holiday World podcast promo code HOWOPO. Simply go to holidayworld.com/save and drop in HOWOPO and let the savings begin.
All right, so what other changes do we have coming this year?
Okay, so this year, what I didn't bring is going to be the fully loaded snacks. That's going to be up at our Santa's Mary Marketplace,
so
which was new.
Excited.
Yeah.
We all know Laura loves something loaded.
Everybody likes loaded.
And then you throw in tater tots. Sold.
And that's in one of our menu meetings, somebody asked, well, do we have to do the tater tots? And I thought of Lauren. I said, yes, you have to do the tater tots.
You have to do the tater tots.
I thought the tater tots came from you, Matt B.
No, they did, Lauren. But I mean, it's all motivated by Lauren, because she loves tater tots.
Please help support me. Please go buy tots.
I'm close behind Lauren with the obsession with tater tots.
Like, oh, because I told him I wanted to axe the tater tots. And he's like, no. Yeah, I wanted to axe the tater tots.
Why is she here?
Lori, I tend to agree
You're
with
welcome,
you.
Lauren.
Do you?
I mean, speaking of potato parts, what is it? What
That's
is a tater
total.
Tot? That's all potato
it's
parts.
It's not all natural potato parts.
No.
You should, like, shred up potatoes and then you mash them back together with other goodies.
Right. And then load them up.
Fully loaded snacks. So what
That's
is fully
potato
loaded
parts.
Snacks
a big red
replacing?
It.
What is it replacing?
So fully loaded snacks is replacing the deli that we had up at Santa's Mary Marketplace.
Which happened to be my favorite part, but it's fine, whatever. So all my favorite things go away.
And all five people who ate there are sad.
Oh, yes. I don't even know if it was five.
Actually, four besides Leah.
It was just me.
If you haven't
went five
been to
times,
the park
guys.
In the last year, we renovated Kringles last year into what's now called Santa's Mary Marketplace. So there's five stations that have distinct menus. So it's sort of a food court setup, lots of different menu items. And, you know, anytime you put something new in, you're always going through and say, okay, what do we want to change in year two? What are things we want to tweak to make the guest experience better? And we listen to our guests, and the guests speak with their feet, whether it's what attraction to put in the park or what food to offer in. The deli just didn't. Nope. Five people went there all season.
Yeah.
That's
yeah.
an interesting analogy.
Speak
I like
with
it.
Their feet. I like it.
They do. They speak with their feet. And so they vote with their feet or speak with their feet. And so anytime we've had a loaded concept where we do loaded fries or loaded tots or loaded nachos, we sell thousands and thousands. So we're like, this will be a good opportunity.
Who doesn't love loaded tots, loaded fries, loaded mac and cheese?
I agree.
Yes.
Like, and so what we're hoping is.
True. I can't fight you on that.
This will also pull some.
Apparently, I'm very contrary today because I was trying to find a way to fight you, but
I can't. You can't.
People, everybody loves our pizza. That's one of our top items. That is our top item up there. But what we're hoping is the loaded bar during those lunch rushes will help kind of even out the line a little bit. We'll get some more people down to that fifth station. So we'll see. See how that works.
So the other stations up there, if you missed it last year, the other stations are, there's an Asian station, and there is an Italian station. There's a kids station that has burgers and hot dogs. And, of course, our fully loaded snacks where you can get waffle fries along with your tater tots. nacho chips and mac and cheese, and you can load it with whatever meat you want. There's four or five different types of meat, and there's other veggies you can put on there. There's
beautiful. Tasty. Yeah, are there jalapenos?
I think she
or
does
something
have
something spicy. Okay.
Yeah. I just need something definitely spicy.
Okay, good.
Bacon. Who doesn't love bacon? There it is.
We've gone so far without bacon.
Yeah.
We love bacon.
I know. That's why
Let's just remember that we went like two full podcast episodes at the beginning of the season.
I don't think
season.
We said bacon in the last one either.
Yeah.
Oh,
we've made a couple episodes now.
We need a bacon t-shirt.
That's a really good idea.
Why didn't we think of that this year?
I don't know.
With all the food merchandise.
We don't have like one signature bacon.
I feel like
I failed. Bacon on everything.
There's always next year.
Yeah. We can do 2021.
See if you make it to next year.
Show me that you want more food merchandise by buying it.
Anyway,
some of the other new food items we have, we've done a lot of things with gluten-free for this year. We've got a new gluten-free chicken bite because our bites we had last year were just
They are so good.
I got to try these new gluten-free
chicken bites.
Yeah. So the new ones are delicious. In fact, I think a lot of us would prefer those over the regular almost.
Yeah.
Yeah. They're really tasty. Good.
And then a Rice Krispie treat that we actually tried today too.
That was really good too.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Oh yeah. Yeah.
Very tasty.
It has brown butter and sea salt.
Yeah.
It was so good.
Yeah.
I've never seen a brown butter.
Me either.
Must be a new thing.
Yeah.
Organic.
Yeah. We'll take it. It was good.
And then also a gluten-free cookie. They call it a Zoe's Crush cookie, which is really good. It's like a loaded cookie. It's got toffee bites in it and chocolate. It's pretty good.
Ooh.
And then some of the other new things we're going to have, a rainbow cake. It is just what it sounds like. It is a cake. It's four or five layers. And there's like a red layer, there's a blue layer, there's a green layer, and a yellow layer.
I'm pulling up the picture you texted me a while ago.
It's tall, it's huge, and it's beautiful. So we're going to have a rainbow cake.
It looks awesome.
For the record, I showed this to the podcast production team. And
wow.
Isn't that awesome? And the comment was like, kids are going to love that.
And Sabrina and
I both raised our hands like, kids. We're going to love that. I will be eating that.
Where will that be?
That'll be at Santa's Mary Marketplace.
Okay.
As a dessert.
Awesome. Okay. Yeah. Nice. And another dessert we're going to find at Santa's Mary Marketplace is cookies and cream mousse.
Oh, it's so
intriguing to me.
It's so good.
Yeah. It'll be delicious. And you'll find that up there as well. One other thing we're going to find in some of our other locations is Dippin' Dots and Totally Bananas. We're going to make your favorite options a little easier to get to. Some of our retail locations will have Dippin' Dots in it. Some of our other food restaurants will have Dippin' Dot coolers in there. Just so, you know, you can get your Dippin' Dot fix quick and easy.
And they're a grab-and-go format. So it's
nice.
What did you call it? It's got the spoon under the lid. It's a grab-and-go format. Yeah. So, if you're not a section of the park that has a Dippin' Dots location, or maybe that particular Dippin' Dots location is not open that day, you can go in and still get your Dippin' Dots and avoid the line. So I think having that product in more locations is going to make it easier for the guests.
So going on to some more new things, we're having a cinnamon churro toffee bite. That'll be going on with our churro things, and that'll be up at Candy Cane Confectionery.
Yep.
I made some churro toffee over Christmas break.
It was delicious.
I did.
Yeah.
Oh, I heard about that. Michael was talking about it.
It was pretty tasty.
As soon as we came back from break, he's like, you should have seen and should have tasted Lauren's toffee bites.
Too bad there was already none left.
One of my favorite things, though, that's going to be food-related for this summer is a pretzel.
Oh, yes.
And it's going to be made by Ben's Pretzels.
Oh, yes.
Yes.
Ben's soft pretzels are amazing. And everyone's going to give me a look here.
Yep.
You don't like pretzels?
Yeah, I'm not a big pretzel person.
What?
But I love Ben's soft pretzels.
So I became obsessed with Ben's pretzels from going to my daughter's dance competitions. I wanted to go to the dance competitions just because I could get a Ben's pretzel. That's sad, but true.
It's fair.
Have you told them that?
What? Did
you know
that?
Told your daughter that.
She was fully aware.
That was the first
thing I did.
Amazing.
So they're going to have a location in the water park plaza, the entrance plaza, where you get your locker and where the changing rooms are at. Right in the center of that plaza, there's going to be a Ben's Soft Pretzels location. They'll be making the pretzels fresh. So they'll be rolling the dough
and making
the pretzels right in front of you. Those pretzels are so good.
I don't even know how to describe it.
Their cheese is really good, too. Like, I don't know what's different about their cheese, but it's...
Oh, I haven't tried that.
It's just good.
It's such a good pretzel.
We're excited about it.
More brown food, you know.
I love a good soft pretzel.
Yeah.
So I will be trekking over there every day.
And you can that salted or cinnamon and sugar.
Oh, salted all the way.
Yeah. I like them both.
But I mean, if you're like, you know, in the plaza, but like waiting for the water park to open, that may be a good time to get a cinnamon sugar one.
Yeah, but I'll get one of the cinnamon donuts that we have.
It's pretty good too.
A cronut.
Yeah.
And for our season pass holders, this is the first time we've had an outside brand come in with food. It's something new we're doing, and we like it because it's an Indiana brand. It's a local, sort of a regional thing that people around Holiday World and Southern Indiana know about Ben's Soft Pretzels. They're going to be honoring your season pass discounts.
Yes.
And the employee discounts.
Most importantly.
So make sure to stop by Ben's Soft Pretzels.
I love it.
Yeah. And we're continuing in 2020, some of the new foods we had in 2019, which was the sugar cream pie, which Matt had talked about.
Yeah.
So who's your favorite?
Is it the official pie of Indiana?
Yeah, I think it
state
is.
Pie.
Yeah.
Yep. Have you guys ever made one of those? They're so easy to make.
We like, didn't.
They're super easy.
Mm-mm. I've never made one.
Why
myself?
Mess with it? Wix makes a beautiful one.
I know. I'm just saying. If I wanted to make one, they're really easy.
Yeah, we have that.
Well, technically, the official state pie is the Wix brand, isn't it?
Oh, really?
Really? It's gotta be, yeah.
It's a specific brand. Yeah, I'm like, how do you get that kind of deal?
No kidding.
Because each person makes
state
a little
amusement
different.
Park or something like that, like state theme park.
Yeah.
No kidding.
Official state. Yeah.
Official.
Yeah, we'll work on that.
We'll work on that.
And we brought that in the fall, so you can find that at Plymouth Rock Cafe and at Santa's Mary Marketplace. Our Asian restaurant that's up in Santa's Mary Marketplace, we're going to continue the orange chicken, the General Tso, beef and broccoli, General Tso cauliflower bites, which
those
we all
those
love.
Those are so yummy.
Yep. Loved those.
Lo mein, fried rice. There's also Italian up there. There's pasta. It's kind of like make your own pasta bowl. You can put marinara or Alfredo or meatballs on it. You can put grilled chicken on it. And, sweet potato fries have stayed on the menu. That's a popular one.
My son loves those.
He's always going to be the happiest.
And New York cheesekake we brought on last year. We're going to keep that.
I love plain cheesecake.
You can't go wrong with cheesecake.
He does.
I was like, y'all need to get desserts up here that are really good, and you need to have plain cheesecake.
He's that acclimated in the air.
He has. Some of the other things we introduced last year was the festive flurries. We had a red velvet festive flurry and a Reese peanut butter cup festive flurry. And if you don't know what that is, it's a cup with ice cream. It's like a flurry. Well, it is a flurry with ice cream.
It's so much like it that it is.
Yeah, that it is. Yes. And then there's like big pieces of red velvet cake on top or big
or cookies
of
or Reese's or whatever.
They were featured
the
in People magazine.
They were.
They're ridiculous in a very good way, but
they're so good.
It's crazy. So good.
And then we're bringing in the peppermint flurry for this year.
Ooh.
Yeah, okay.
So Lisa's been trying to experiment a little bit with the peppermint flurry.
I tested the flavors the other day, and it was I'm not a big peppermint person, but I liked it.
Same here.
I don't like peppermint ice cream. Peppermint ice cream is like not my thing.
Yeah, no, that's awful to me.
Me too. Well, we have the same palate, I think.
Sometimes.
Except for Big Red.
Yeah, no.
Yeah,
love Big Red.
There's that.
Oh, Big Red's coming back. Up to the front of the park.
That was my special request.
We had Big Red in Kringles.
Santa's Mary Marketplace.
Do we have time really quick to talk about the Big Red Flood?
we've talked about it before on the podcast,
we've talked
actually.
About it. Okay. That's another iconic moment in our history.
Yeah. So we'll talk about that another time. But Big Red will be coming to Santa's Mary Marketplace this year.
Yep.
So for those of you that love your Big Red,
yes.
You'll be able to get it at even more locations in the park.
Sabrina's doing a happy dance over here, so we have another one, Leah.
Well, I complained to the food and beverage team this year because people came up to me in Marketplace and asked me why we got rid of Big Red.
And you didn't have a good answer, did you?
We
can't explain it.
We still had Big Red in the park, they thought we had gotten rid of it in the entire park because it wasn't up at Marketplace.
We still had it. Speaking of tea, we're also bringing back the tea urns at several locations.
Yeah, that was another thing that people were not happy about.
Those are coming back.
They're coming back.
Yeah. We hear you.
Everybody
people.
Can
we
calm
hear
down.
You.
We haven't had the tea urns, I think, since 2017, and we're bringing those back.
Yeah.
So get excited.
Back. Haven't heard the end of it.
Love it.
And one of the other things we're going to bring back that we brought in at the end of last year, we just tried it at the end. We tried to do it earlier in the year, but the supply and demand, the supply was too high.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Or no,
the demand was too high.
The supply was low. And that's the Impossible Burger. We'll have that at Wilde Bistro, I think. Mm-hmm. And
Santa's Mary Marketplace.
And Santa's Mary Marketplace and Goblin Burgers. And we also made a Impossible Burger taco meat. So you'll find that at Alamo for a non-meat version. And that'll also be at Santa's Mary Marketplace for the Loaded Bar. We'll put Impossible Burger up there. And then, speaking of food, if you're coming to the park to eat, when do you want to come eat? Early and often.
Yes. Right? I was going to say all the time.
Or late.
Early or late, but... You know, if you want to avoid the lines, and a lot of our frequent visitors kind of, they figure these things out, but everybody wants to eat at lunchtime.
Yes.
And, you know, when you're feeding thousands and thousands of people during an hour period, you're going to have lines on those busier days at some of our more popular restaurants. So if you want to avoid those lines, start at typically 11. Mm-hmm. Or, you know, if you want to have a late lunch, maybe come 2:30 to your favorite restaurant, and you're definitely going to have a shorter wait.
We have lots of snacks.
You can always get a snack to kind of keep yourself until later in the afternoon. But
Yeah.
Go get a really good or a pretzel.
Yep.
Hold you over.
Oh, yeah. Pretzel.
Okay.
Lori didn't bring us any Ben's pretzels today.
No, she's not Ben, so she can't make them.
Okay,
yeah,
fine.
We could make them.
All right, whatever.
Only Ben can make Ben's.
Fine.
Congratulations. You've chowed your way to the end of another episode. Lauren just shakes her head at me every time I say it. Please join us in 2 weeks for your commute, cleaning session, etc. for Season 2, Episode 10, the one where we attempted to crowdsource. Thank you to all our Behind the Seeds Pod Squad. Sabrina, for telling people when to show up with food. That's the most important job today. Josh for being my joke testing ground this week. And to both of you for pretending I'm not losing it all week. Special thanks to Stephen for patiently reminding me to write the podcast descriptions and to write the podcast descriptions and to write the podcast description. It took me forever, guys, to get back to it.
I'm
very patient. Special thanks to Chandler and Lisa for helping make sure we got our delicious lunch at 10 a.m.
Yes, thank you, Chandler and Lisa.
Great job. And thanks to all of you for listening. Please subscribe and leave a review on iTunes, Spotify, Google Podcasts, YouTube, Facebook, etc. And tell all your friends on behalf of our pod squad today, Matt, Lauren, Lori, and myself, thank you. Please be sure to share your feedback and questions with us by calling us at 812-937-4401, then dial 8081, or by emailing us at podcast@holidayworld.com, or by reaching out to us on social media using the hashtag HOWOPO.
You've been listening to the official Holiday World Podcast.
Welcome back. Did you enjoy your flight?
A production of Holiday World and Splash and Safari in Santa Claus, Indiana. Check out the latest episodes at holidayworld.com/podcast. Thanks for taking a ride with us.
And please come back to see us again soon.
Do you like dipping your feet in water?
In the water park.
Do you like pushing buttons?
On ride control panels.
How about long walks on the beach?
Of our wave pools.
Or beautiful views?
From the top of coaster hills.
Do you have experience with cannonballing into pools?
I believe those are called compact jumps.
Do you have experience buckling seatbelts?
That one kind of speaks for itself.
This summer, pick the job that creates memories and fun for you, coworkers, and our guests. The attractions department offers positions for ride operators, slide attendants, and lifeguards.
Our slogan is two parks, one team, one mission. That mission is to be a safety and efficiency-driven team offering top-notch operations at two world-class parks.
Come join the attractions team at Holiday World and Splash and Safari.
We want you to be part of our attractions family.